Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick here in South Carolina. I already made a video praying for the oil, and I wanted to redo it because I got off topic. Hey, can you believe it? Anyway, brothers and sisters, here's the oil. I've already got one. I've got a label on there. Praise God for that. Little bottles. And the people who live in Australia and England who asked me for oil, you know, I don't know what it's going to cost to send, but by the grace of God, we're going to do that. And the people that ask for some, you know, if you ask for some from overseas, outside of the United States and Canada, I just pray that you know that you would consider that it's going to be a whole lot more expensive to ship. We had experienced that before with the books sending to Australia and England. But anyway, brothers and sisters, I have these glass bottles with lids. I showed this the other day. And then I put them in these little druggy bags. And then I'm going to put it in a padded envelope. You know, and I've got those here. And I'm out of envelopes. I got to get more envelopes. I've already, you know, got them all. I haven't put them in there yet, but I've got all of them labeled. And anyway, brothers and sisters, I have them all packed up and shipping out the, you know, all the envelopes I have tomorrow into America and Canada. For those of you who are in Europe or in Australia and other locations, I'm going to get plastic bottles, and I should be getting them sometime, hopefully this week, next week. And once I get the plastic bottles, I want to, you know, I'll save the glass bottles as a backup, or I will use those for American addresses. I think the glass bottle is nice to have, you know, and I think it'll be all right in here. But shipping to Australia and England is so expensive, and it's so far, and it would be such a waste if the bottles were broken. Plus, you know, being flown and all that, you know, it might become frozen or something. Who knows? I don't know. It might break, whatever. So I go with the plastic bottles for overseas for sure. And like I say, I'll be using plastic exclusively after I'm going to get all the glass bottles out. Anyway, brothers and sisters, praise God. Praise God. Let's pray for this oil. I've already been praying for it. Brother Sid came to visit me. We prayed over the oil and already made a video praying over it. Like I say, I'm going to redo it, though. And all you guys just pray. Even if you watch this video a year from now, this is November the 5th, I think it is, 2014. You can watch this video 5 years from now, Lord willing, if the Lord hasn't returned for his people. You can pray with me now, 5 years from now, and it would still have a prayer impact. Because God and prayers are outside time. They're in eternity, brothers and sisters. So let's pray in agreement over this oil right now, okay? And I've got more oil right here. I've got lots of oil. I've got about, I got about 3 or 4 liters of oil. A gallon. So let's pray over it. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the Most High God, Lord, we come in agreement right now. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We come in agreement. As you said, two are more gathered in your name. There you are in the midst of them. Lord, you said or two or more touching in agreement on anything, and it'll be bound on earth and bound in heaven, and loosed on earth and loosed in heaven, Lord, as we pray. So, Lord, we come in agreement right now for this anointing oil to be filled with our prayer, with our faith right now for salvations in Jesus' name. That all who are anointed with this oil, their bedposts are anointed with this oil, the doorway of their house is anointed with this oil, or they are anointed with this oil, that the Spirit of the living God of conviction would come up upon them for salvation in Jesus' name, that they would repent. Lord, that you would light a fire under them, Lord, and press them and squeeze them and sweat them under conviction of sin in Jesus' name, Lord, for salvation. Lord, we believe this oil is filled with the power of healing. It is a point of contact and full of faith. And we come in agreement that all that are anointed with this oil and prayed over will be healed physically, spiritually, mentally. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. I believe that everyone that's we come in agreement anyone that's anointed with this oil would have a financial breakthrough, mental breakthrough, spiritual breakthrough, healing breakthrough, physical breakthroughs, hallelujah, favor breakthroughs for jobs, for, you know, the right pay, fair pay that they deserve for their job, Lord. Hallelujah, there are people that are underpaid, people that are not treated properly at work and in their life, they would have favor, Lord. I speak that this anointing oil would be filled with your favor, Lord God. Hallelujah, that you would give your people favor with both God and man, Lord. For you said when a man's ways are pleasing to you, Lord, even his enemies would be at rest with him. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Lord. Let all who are anointed this oil, Lord, let their ways be guided into all paths of righteousness for you, Lord. As you said, you would guide us and lead us, Lord, into paths of righteousness for your name's sake, Lord. Hallelujah. We just release, Lord, our faith, our love, our relationship with you, Lord. We put it in this oil right now in Jesus' name, Lord. For your word says that any sick among you, call for the elders of the church, anointing them with oil in the name of the Lord, and the prayer of faith shall heal the sick. And Lord, we're coming together as the elders of Church of the Firstborn. Hallelujah, Lord. We're coming in agreement and praying over this oil right now, that whoever is anointed with this oil, or their bed post is anointed, their doorposts are anointed, their car is anointed. Hallelujah, that the elders of the Church of the Firstborn has touched in agreement with this person who would do the anointing right now in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name, in Jesus' name, that it be done. Hallelujah, hallelujah, in Jesus' name. Hallelujah, we have the victory. We have the victory, and this is our point of contact, brothers and sisters. It's a point of faith. It's a point of contact. Just like Paul, he touched handkerchiefs, and they sent them out to people, and they touched people, and they were healed. Peter's shadow fell on people and healed them. It was a matter of faith, and the anointing of Peter, the anointing of Paul, and the faith of those who were touched by the handkerchief and by the shadow of Peter. Brothers and sisters, we're coming together in our anointing together, brothers and sisters. Our anointing, as the Bible says, one can put 1,000 to flight. Two can put 10,000 to flight. Amen. So multiply that times 300 or 400 people who would pray in agreement with us. Hallelujah. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Let's worship the Lord. Brothers and sisters, Brother Sid told me last night when he came here, Brother Sid is the one who's the head of the prayer team. And the website, Church of the Firstborn, the website link is below all of my videos under the See More. Click on that section under the websites. And Brother Sid was saying, look, Brother Patrick, yeah, I've got about 5,000 subscribers. There's no reason why we don't have 1% of the people on the prayer team. That's 50 people. Right now we've got 15 people on the prayer team. We need at least 50. There's no reason why we don't have 500. Let's come in agreement. 10%, a tithe of the people who subscribe to my channel will be prayer warriors. Sign up to be a prayer warrior. Email Brother Sid on the website. It's sydney@churchfirstborn.com. Go down to the website, churchfirstborn.com, and talk with Sid. And then Sid will talk to me. And you can talk to me too. Put you on the prayer team. We send out prayer alerts. We don't get that many, just 3 or 4 a week. We send them out and ask you to pray for those people. And if you get a word from the Lord, respond. You know, lots of you want to operate in the power of God, and you're Dead Sea Christians. You know, the Dead Sea, the Jordan River runs into the Dead Sea, but it doesn't run out. You know, but we need to be like the Sea of Galilee, where the River Jordan runs into the top of the Sea of Galilee, then flows out the bottom on down to the Dead Sea. You know, we want the anointing. A lot of you guys say, oh yeah, I want to be baptized in the Holy Spirit. I want to speak in tongues. I want to operate in the gift of prophecy. I want to operate, you know, in the gift of interpretation, whatever, gifts of healing. But yet you don't want to pray for anybody. You don't want to be involved. You don't want to do anything for anybody but yourself. Me, 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 me. I want a word. I want a word. But not, hey, let God use me to give somebody else a word. Let God use me to minister to somebody else. Hallelujah. Get off your blessed assurance, my friends, and let's get busy doing the kingdom of God's work. This don't cost anything. You got an email. You're obviously on the internet. It don't cost anything to receive prayer requests. Lord knows, you know, it won't cost you a penny to receive the emails and pray for people. Give your time, give your heart, give your energy to the service of the Lord. Can you give a few minutes to the Lord God Almighty? Besides just, you know, when you're watching videos, it's just, you know, it's all about you and your own personal growth. What about giving, offering yourself as a living sacrifice, praising God, and let God use you as an instrument for somebody else? You know, be a vessel. God says, I look for some man to stand in the gap, but I couldn't find anybody. That's why he brought judgment on Israel. He was looking for at least one person to stand in the gap and intercede for the nation, and he couldn't find nobody. And that's what's wrong with America. You know how many people contact me all the time, say, Brother Patrick, nobody else. I don't hear anybody preaching but you, really. Nobody preaches like you. And, you know, and a dozen people have told me that, at least, in the last week or two. It's sad. There's not hardly anybody people. The people that are trying to preach, it's all people-pleasing stuff. It's all, you know, rah, rah, rah. It's all rah, 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 preaching to the choir. Let's pray, brothers and sisters. I don't want to be getting on people too much, but, you know, I've got to do what I got to do, because it's from the Lord, God Most High, Creator of heaven and earth. Let's pray. Hallelujah. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, Son of the Most High God, hallelujah. Lord, I call forth your people to serve you, Lord God, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Father, call your people to service, Lord God. Put a fire in their heart, Lord, that they'd stop thinking about themselves all the time and their own personal spiritual journey. All that Joel Osteen in. Lord, let them be called to a life of sacrifice and service and giving. Hallelujah, Father, in the name of Jesus. Brothers and sisters, like I say, there's nothing that's more irritating in the flesh to me than someone that gets on YouTube and goes around criticizing and trying to, you know, have theological debates with people. And I mean, in this case, myself, about, you know, the smallest little tittle of a doctrinal dispute among different groups, calling people all kinds of names, false prophets, when, you know, the positions, as an example, the positions I have are held by millions of people, you know, millions of people in the different denominations, not just an individual belief that I have that no one else in the world has. You know, that's usually when you're looking at some kind of a false doctrine. You know, there's different beliefs in different denominations. Millions of people have that belief, either in a pre-tribulation rapture or they don't believe in the pre-tribulation rapture or whatever. It's not just a one person's idea. People on the internet running to and fro debating the minorest thing, but yet they're a shut-in living in their, you know, in their, you know, their parents' garage. Never done, never prayed with a single person or for a single person. Never evangelized a single person. Never done anything for the Lord. As a matter of fact, people that know them, if they do go out in the daytime, instead of going out at night as, you know, some kind of a vampire, when they do go out in public and meet people, people wouldn't know they were a Christian at all by the way they act. No salt and light, no influence upon anybody or anything in this world. Only living in the, you know, in the virtual reality of their own mind, in their own personal, you know, a spiritual quest to know everything and to be a know-it-all, you know, and be some kind of a self-appointed part-time high theologian. Brothers and sisters, there's many people on the internet like that. That's the downside of the internet, brothers and sisters. People are emboldened to, you know, to be obnoxious and rude that they would never say to your face, but they can, hiding by the anonymity of the internet. And they're sad, sad people, brothers and sisters. And I pray those of you who are watching this who fall into that category. You know, the Lord sent me to preach the good news to all categories, including trolls, including shut-ins, including self-appointed, self-righteous hypocrites, whoever you may be. The Bible verse that the Lord gave me tonight is from John, the Gospel of John, chapter 1, verse 12. It's talking about the Lord Jesus. As many as received him, to them he gave power to become the sons of God, even to those who believe on his name. That's the Bible verse that the Lord gave me tonight. So the Lord is calling you to become a child of God. The original Greek text, the text was originally Greek, yes, not Hebrew, and it says in there to become children of God. But of course, that's an example. King James uses the masculine word sons of God, but the original text is a child of God, to become a child of God. Brothers and sisters, friends, those who are watching this video, God wants you to be one of his children and adopt a child into the kingdom of the Lord Jesus Christ. Today is the day of salvation. Today is the day for you to reach for the high calling and the destiny that God has predestined for you. As he says in his word, whom he foreknew, he did predestine to be conformed to the image of Jesus Christ. God has a destiny for each and every one of you. And I guarantee you, it is not to live in your parents' garage and go on the internet and be an obnoxious jerk and stumble other people. His destiny for you is to be born again Christian, to become a son or daughter of God, and to be salt and light in this world, to be offering yourself as a living sacrifice, you know, a meat for the master's use, to become a vessel that is good enough for the master's use, that the Lord could transform you by the renewing of your mind in his word, by his spirit, to be led by his spirit. For the Bible says, Romans 8:16, those who are led by the, Romans 8:14, those who are led by the Spirit, these are the children of God. Hallelujah. Be led by His Spirit. Become a child of God. Serve Him. No man can serve two masters, as Jesus talked about. Many of you, it's not even money that's your master, but yourself. You are your own master, the captain of your own ship, the leader of your own destiny. But God has called us that we would surrender the throne of our heart and let the Lord sit on the throne of our heart. By the grace of the Most High God, may the Lord have His place in your heart today. May you surrender right now. Pray with me. Just pray. You know, it's not a matter of saying all these set prayers. Call on the name of the Lord. Say, Lord Jesus, forgive me. I'm a sinner. I cannot save myself. I cannot deliver myself. I've told lies. Your word says that all liars have their place in the lake of fire. I've taken things that didn't belong to me. Well, you said in your word, thou shalt not steal. I've looked on men or women with lust. Some of you, maybe you've looked on both. Whatever, that's a little extra category there too. We've all sinned and fallen short of the glory of God, the Bible says. There's none righteous, no, not one. Nobody's perfect. No one's in righteous means, remember this, righteousness means right standing with God. You are not right standing with God except through the blood of Yeshua HaMashiach, Jesus the Messiah. Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me, Jesus said. Hallelujah. No one comes to the Father except through Jesus. Now, brothers and sisters, I started out to pray for this oil. And if I label this video prayer for oil, only you who are watching this, probably that don't need to hear this message. Those who need to hear it, they won't be watching a video about oil. God bless you, brothers and sisters. You know I love you. You know that I'm here for you. You know I spend lots of time talking to people on the phone who are having situations, and it's a regular thing, and that's part of the ministry, brothers and sisters. You know, I can't make videos all the time because, I'm trying to minister to people and help people. And then I got to, you know, the orphanages and the feeding programs, and I have to deal with the pastors and the house parents in the Philippines and all that stuff. You know, there's always something going on, like the vehicle was broke down, our van, I asked you to pray about it. The van engine has had trouble twice. We've had to pay to get it fixed. Brothers and sisters, I pray, maybe we need to sell it and get another one. That's because this one seems to be having problems. You know, we need to pray about all that, brothers and sisters. I appreciate your prayer on that. And brothers and sisters, I just want to thank you.